Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. How many times has this happened to you? I know, it's frightening, feeling like your ability to interact with the digital world is suddenly severed. But science to the rescue, because we have a simple solution. Just find an outlet and a cord, and you'll be back to texting and scrolling in no time. Thinking about our last few lessons on energy, how is this possible? What kind of energy is going into your phone, and where did it come from? Our phones need electrical energy, which we know we can get from the outlets in our homes. That electrical energy likely came from a power plant, possibly one that used the chemical energy stored in fossil fuels. And those fossil fuels only had chemical energy because millions of years ago, they used photosynthesis to convert radiant energy from the sun into food. So, is all energy interchangeable then? Does it even matter what form energy is in if it can be converted to other forms equally? And are all energy forms equal, or do we lose some energy when we make these transactions? These are the questions we'll explore today. But before we plug in, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to describe Joule's contribution to physics with his paddle wheel experiment, give examples of energy transformations, and explain the theory of conservation of energy. Today, our exploration of energy actually begins back in the 1800s with a scientist by the name of James Prescott Joule. His family owned a brewery, and he grew up with a fascination for watching the brewing equipment, often seeing a connection between heat and work. As the machines churned harder, both the equipment and the liquid inside heated up. When they stopped working, everything cooled down. Joule was fascinated by the idea that different forms of energy, like kinetic energy and heat, were interconnected. To explore this connection, he designed an apparatus known as the paddle wheel and used it for an experiment in the 1840s. To collect the data, Joule immersed a paddle wheel in a container filled with water. This paddle wheel was connected to weights, and when released, the weights would fall, causing the paddle wheel to churn the water inside. Friction between the water and the paddles generated heat, increasing the water's temperature. Joule meticulously measured the amount of mechanical work done by the kinetic energy of the falling weights and the corresponding rise in temperature of the water. He found a consistent relationship. The amount of mechanical work done by the moving weights was always equal to the amount of energy gained by the water in the form of heat. So, what are the monumental implications of Joule's seemingly simple experiment? Well, Joule's paddle wheel experiment demonstrated that energy could be converted from one form to another, but it could not be created or destroyed. The energy that a system begins with will be the energy that it ends with, even if the type of energy changes. This led to the development of the first law of thermodynamics and the theory of energy conservation, which we will learn more about later in this lesson. A plaque on Joule's home in England commemorates his contributions to physics, and as a lasting tribute, the unit of energy, the joule, is named after him. Let's consider a scenario you're all familiar with, eating food. When you munch on your favorite snack, the stored chemical energy in the food must be transformed. As you savor every bite, your body gets busy. Digestive enzymes break down the complex molecules in food, preparing to release the stored chemical energy. what types of energy do you think it will get transformed into? Your body has a lot going on and needs lots of different types of energy. Feel like running, jumping, or swimming? That's the transformed energy at play. Some of the chemical energy gets transformed into kinetic energy, powering your muscles and allowing you to move and interact with the world. What about shivering in the cold on a chilly day outside? Your body uses the energy from food to produce thermal energy or heat, maintaining your body temperature and keeping you warm. Ever had a light bulb moment? The energy from your food is also converted into electrical energy, allowing your neurons to fire and helping your brain to think, learn, and create. And if you want to start belting out your favorite song as you drive down the road, well, some of that chemical energy from your food will have to be transformed into sound energy. Those are only a few of the energy transformations that go on in your body. And of course, many other transformations have to occur all around you, all day long. Think about the electrical energy that comes to your house from the power plant. What type of energy transformations does it undergo once in your house? See if you can think of at least three examples. Pause the video for a moment to record them in your notes. Did you think of some ideas? The possibilities are nearly endless, but here are some common transformations you may have thought of. Electrical energy being converted into radiant energy, or light, from any device with a screen. Electrical energy being converted to thermal energy, or heat, which keeps your house warm and cooks your food. And electrical energy being converted to kinetic energy to run fans and kitchen appliances such as blenders. Right now, you're watching this video on some sort of device that uses electrical energy. If you're watching it on a laptop computer, your device is probably consuming around 30 joules of energy every second, or using 30 watts of power. That energy enters your computer as electrical energy, either directly from the outlet in the wall, or as stored electrical energy from the battery. What happens to that 30 joules of energy that your computer is fed every second? As you watch this video, your computer is probably converting around 8 joules per second to radiant energy, or light, to produce the images you are seeing on the screen. Another 1 joule of electrical energy is being converted to sound energy each second, so that you hear my voice. And other random sounds at times. Producing light and sound are the two most important tasks of a computer. But so far, we've only accounted for 9 joules out of the 30 joules the computer consumes every second. What is happening to the other 21 joules? Unfortunately, they are being converted to heat. Heat is a common byproduct of any energy transformation, and unless we are actually using the computer to stay warm, this is considered wasted energy, or an inefficiency. But regardless of what form of energy it is being converted to, all of the electrical energy that goes into a computer will come back out. This is the law of conservation of energy. It says that energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can only change forms. After all, it has to come from one of the energy sources we discussed in our previous lesson, and most of those sources are simply transforming energy that originally came to Earth from the sun. So, energy doesn't spontaneously appear, but the energy we have is here to stay. Some forms of energy may be more useful than others, though. Creating machines and devices that are capable of transforming a higher percentage of electrical energy to these useful forms instead of wasting it as heat will continue to be an area of research and development. As we went through the lesson today, we saw how James Prescott Joule revolutionized our thinking about energy transformations with a simple experiment. Using his paddle wheel, he discovered that all of the mechanical work being done by his setup was transformed to heat in the water. Energy is transformed every time we eat food and every time we use devices that require any type of energy or work. The one constant is that the total amount of energy in a system will remain constant, even if it is converted into different forms. Next time, we'll wrap up this unit with a more in-depth look at a specific form of energy, heat. Hope you're ready to get warm. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.